What if you could use an FPV camera and headset to immerse yourself in an underwater world and control what you see by moving your head? I built this big 3D printed RC boat a little while back. We're going to remove the water sample module fitted here to make way for a dome-based underwater camera system. But why bother with a dome when I could just strap an action camera under the boat? Because light bends differently in air and water. If we use a regular lens surrounded by water, more refraction occurs and not all light is able to enter the lens, resulting in distortion and objects appearing closer than they actually are. But if we add an air-filled dome to move the water away from the lens, less refraction occurs due to the air and more light enters the lens to provide a better representation of objects. In our case, the dome will be horizontal underneath the boat. And without a dome, you just can't get shots like these.
When I first designed this boat, I envisaged one of these little domes in the bow that would house a fixed FPV camera. I never went ahead and did that. I did go ahead and get a slightly larger dome. This one's 200 millimeters, and this is big enough to house a pan and tilt FPV camera.
The acrylic dome was vacuum formed and drilled for me, but they did a poor job with the hole spacing, meaning that I had to do a workaround to get the correct dimensions into my design. The dome design is simple. It provides a mount for the cameras and lighting. I've added a link in the description if you want to check out the design in more detail. I printed the dome mount in PLA Plus filament. Then I printed it again due to a major design flaw. Two coats of polyester resin were added to keep the water out. And silicone sealant was applied to form a seal between the mount and dome before tightening down the fasteners and leaving it to cure for a day or so. A lighting system on the camera itself wasn't going to work, and infrared was not the way to go. I needed lots of light, and hey, I love LED strips. Using 25mm acrylic tube that was destined for another project, I printed some fittings to hold the lights, which the manufacturer rated as kind of waterproof. Until I cut them, that is. But a bit of hot glue will sort that out. I printed these on a glass bed so the self-adhesive stuck well. Some more 3D printed fittings, a stick of hot glue, and then a splash of polyester resin, and these things would want to be waterproof. The lights attached to the dome using some custom 3D printed action camera style fittings. The dome is done. Onto the pan and tilt mechanism. And no need to reinvent the wheel on this one. I used a cheap kit that uses two micro servos. But I did want to mash up an analog FPV cam for the live feed and an action camera to record in HD. Buying a Cadex P-Nut would have been the perfect solution, but I already had the other cameras and instead designed a mount to fit both cameras to the pan and tilt mechanism. And to reduce the likelihood of reflection inside the dome, I blacked them out. This tiny little thing will allow me to use my head to control the camera direction. Inside we have an Arduino Nano BLE 33, a mono socket, and a tactile switch. There is zero coding here thanks to the great work of Cliff and a very intuitive GUI. A link to their GitHub is in the description. It's tiny enough to stick on your FPV goggles. Now it was time to wire everything up and make sure everything is waterproof-ish.
Inside the control box we have another receiver, so that's now the second on board the boat. We have a step-down voltage converter and a receiver-controlled switch. We've got power coming in here, wiring out to the FPV camera here, wiring out to the lights here, and wiring to the video transmitter here. To connect the head tracker, we have one cable for power and one cable connects to the RC transmitter.
Everything is working on the bench. This is the function I forgot to add in the initial design, a way to remove the cameras. The dome fits to the deck using bolts and wing nuts, and there are three cables to connect.
Wow, this is even better than I imagined. It really feels like you're underwater. A little awkward to control when I'm standing in a pool.
the lights are working. And everything stayed dry. But what about the lights at night? As well as attracting bugs, they did a pretty good job underwater. So it's off to give it a proper test in the wild. I live inland and clear water is hard to come by, so I head to one of Australia's highest mountains a couple of hours away that has the clearest water around. Around these parts, it's basically illegal not to stop at the lookout. And then I arrived at Lake Catani, fed by clear alpine waters. Before launching, I checked over the boat and everything was working, except for the analog feed from the FPV cam. I had no signal in my goggles, which makes the system pretty much useless. But I did take the opportunity to take the boat out for a drive and record some regular video. The water is so clear here that it's hard to tell that this shot is actually underwater. The shadow of the boat gives away some indication of the depth. I stuck a camera on a rock by the shore and managed to find this little fella. But this is cheating. I want to capture a fish FPV. I headed back down the mountain, unloaded the van, grabbed some parts from a drone, squeezed them on board, had a battery fire in my workshop, then hit the road again, but to a different destination this time. Ye olde Beechworth. Hashtag Beechworth. The home of a bakery and a lake that's not nearly as clear as the last one, but it'll do the job. The lake is home to these cute little ducks, and these fish. With some nasty weather on the way, I set up quickly. The water is not nearly as clear here, but this is about as good as it gets in my backyard. After a quick run around, I headed to a reed bed that looked like pretty good fish habitat. My technique here was to park the boat and have a look around. This is much more interesting than the pool. It really felt like I was exploring because everything I saw under there was new. I spotted these fish in my goggles, but I wanted to see something a little bigger. That's more like it. And I got a bit excited at this one. I was happy enough to have found these fish, but that's all I could find. And then I had to pack up as the weather started rolling in. So what have I learned from this? Once I ironed out the bugs, the system actually worked pretty well. But it is a little cumbersome with two radios, goggles and multiple cameras to look after. It was a little difficult seeing detail at the peripherals of my goggles, and I put that down to the low quality analog feed. I've been wanting to change over from analog to digital FPV for a while now, and I think it would be a great upgrade for this project. The dome displaces about 2 kilograms of water, which I didn't find to be a huge issue, but it definitely slowed the boat down a little. Not such a problem for this kind of mission. So I didn't need to use the lights during the day, but it has got me wondering what I might find underwater at night. Let me know in the comments if you have any suggestions or ideas for this system, or any others that you'd like me to try out on the boat.